Hi, so I'll try and brief you guys about the defamation case and its present status. I made a video last night actually. It was a very lengthy video briefing about the status of the defamation case, and I ended up not posting it. I ended up deleting it because it just got too complicated, too repetitive. It's a bit difficult to brief in a way that makes sense and is at the same time short and interesting. But I'm going to try again tonight. Before I do that, let me just say a few words about what happened today. I was with my lawyer and at the High Court all day because some papers needed to be filed. These are the papers which are replies to the plaint and to the first notice of motion in the defamation case, and these are very technical, very long, but at the same time very important and necessary parts of the my defense. And I have filed them with all due care and caution. My defense says everything that I need to say to the judge, to the court, to the system, so to speak, because in the end it is not going to be about an individual judge, it is going to be about the system. So these are my statements to the system, my replies to the system. These are public documents. I will be sharing them with all of you probably tomorrow. I'll scan and post them. And I'll also post soft copies, word files of my replies, because you guys are stakeholders, all of you. Many of you have contributed to the cause fairly large amounts, and some of you small amounts. I continue to receive small amounts like 500 rupees on Paytm till date. And it is heartening that so many of you feel invested in this case. I'm very happy, I'm very grateful to all of you for supporting me in this case and considering this case to be yours. So I'm going to share that information with you, and I will probably make a video reading the case and explaining the plaint, explaining my defense to you guys, so that you are on the same page as me. I hope it helps you all in some way in understanding the legal system, in understanding where we are at. I wanted to tell you about my day. So I was at the High Court and with my lawyer who's at CST. My lawyer is not representing me, he's helping me. Advocate Sushant, he is helping me with my paperwork. He is guiding me and interpreting a lot of things which are difficult for me to understand. And on the way back, I ended up catching a Virar train, Virar fast instead of a Borivali fast by mistake. Ended up falling asleep around Dadar, and when I woke up, I had reached Daisar. So then I got down at Mira Road from this crowded train. It was not too crowded, but it was crowded. And on my way back, I saw this eunuch, Pooja. And the important, I made this video with her when I got down at Borivali. What was striking was that she was so pleasant. She was such a pleasure to watch. Most of the times I have found I have rarely had a pleasant interaction or a pleasant experience with any eunuch, any member of the eunuch, the Hijra community. I always find them to be, well, not very pleasant to deal with, and I respond quite badly to their style of communication. But this person, Pooja, was so pleasant. I watched how she engaged with children and women and everybody in the railway compartment. She was such a pleasure to watch. And when I got down from the train, you know, I felt moved to show my appreciation. And it wasn't only me. There is another guy who also was doing the same thing. He was responding in the same way as I was responding, you know. We both went up to Pooja and said, "Listen, you are a very charming member of your community. So thank you for just being you. Thank you for being so pleasant. Thank you for being so wonderful. You change our view of your entire community, and you are a very good representative of your people." So that was the interaction I had, and as an afterthought I took that video, and that person was Pooja Sharma, very modest, very gentle. Anyways, coming back to the defamation, so this is the interim relief stage. It is pre-admission. The case has not yet been admitted. All the reliefs, all the arguments that have happened so far has been regarding giving interim relief to the plaintiff, and the interim relief that the plaintiff wants is deletion of my videos and so on, which I am opposing. And this is even prior to the admission of the case. Now the case will have to be heard to be admitted, and let me tell you that if it is admitted, what happens with civil cases, because this is a civil case, civil defamation suit, what happens with civil cases is that it goes into cold storage after admission for 4-5 years. That is because there is such a long queue of pendency at Bombay High Court that all civil cases that are admitted will be heard only after 5 years or 6 years or maybe more, 7 years, long period of time. And after that, when the hearings start happening, when you start getting dates, you'll get a date once in 3 months or once in 6 months. And at some point, because the court does not have time for examining the evidences, the evidences will be examined by court commissioners. And the court commissioners will, of course, make videos and keep transcripts, and it will be quite detailed. But I, of course, want the proceedings themselves to be video recorded. So the initial part of our hearings are going to be about video recording of the case itself. I'm going to press for that, and there is a reason I'm pressing for that. The reason is that the arbitrariness of the system, the judges, the counsels, the way they interact together, their arbitrariness can be fatal to my cause. We have a very powerful opponent, very resourceful opponent. The builder is very resourceful, has lots of money, lots of legal talent at his disposal, can engage the best. And on the other side, here I am. But what I have on my side is that I'm fighting for a public cause. I have been a bad boy in the eyes of the system. I am arguably committed contempt, defied court orders, etc. And that is going to be their side of the argument also. Not to mention that I have made videos about the conduct of judges and so on. So all of that makes my case more difficult, more, it is the kind of thing that would make it more difficult for me to get a fair hearing at the court, because these are things that would predispose the court to look at me in a less favorable light. So my argument is that if the court is to be at all just and impartial to me, then it is crucial that all the hearings, all the proceedings of the court should be recorded, audio video recorded, to prevent any possibility of arbitrariness and an uneven playing field for me. This is going to be the substance of my argument. But anyway, what I would like to repeat is that I have, just as a kind of a wrap-up, a nutshell, I am in the process of replying, filing my affidavits in reply. And on 25th, we may not possibly have an effective hearing. It may be just a date where people will seek adjournment. The opposite side may seek another date. That is, they may seek an adjournment because they will probably want to file a surrejoinder, and they will want time to file a surrejoinder. A rejoinder to my rejoinder, my reply. And because my reply is quite voluminous and quite detailed and supported with lots of documents, evidences, there is a small possibility, I would say there is a decent possibility that the case itself would be dismissed by the court. That is what, of course, I am asking for. I am asking for that, for the defamation case to be dismissed completely. I have grounds, fairly strong grounds that I have made out, which I will read out and explain to you, my grounds for seeking the dismissal. And if it is dismissed, then of course the whole thing will end within the next one or two or three hearings. The entire defamation case will be dismissed. That is one possibility. And of course the other possibility is that it will be admitted, and then it will be heard only 5 or 6 years later. In the meanwhile, there is also one more possibility, that the other side may offer something called consent terms. They may say, listen, we are going to do this, this, this. These are the actions that we are going to take. And in return for these actions, you withdraw your videos and you withdraw your, articles. And this is, and then the whole thing will be drawn up into an agreement, if it is suitable, and then taken before the court, and we tell the court that, listen, we have agreed on these terms. It's pretty normal to do this in civil proceedings. It's called civil consent and consent terms. So there is a possibility that if they don't get any reliefs in the interim stage, they will find that the only thing, the only sensible thing left to do is to offer consent terms and withdraw the case in return for some kind of consideration from my side. That is, I delete some videos, etc. And the question, of course, arises, why would I delete videos? Why would I delete articles which I hold to be true and which I hold to be genuine and of value to the public? So that is a question that will have to be answered in a proper and genuine way. They will have to come up with some good reasons why that. And I'm not saying money. I'm not saying, hey, listen, pay me, guys, and I'm going to withdraw it. That's not the point. The point is, you need to address the problems. And if the problems are addressed, then I might consider withdrawing or deleting the videos and articles. This is one possibility of how the whole thing can go. So let us wait and see. If you have any questions, please feel free to ask questions in the comments and I'll do my best to reply to them. Thank you, guys, and good night.